This is our dog, Scout. We adopted him from a rescue in Mexico in March 2023. Here he was just a few days before we adopted him, and a few days later, he was here in cold and snowy Montreal. And if you ask Scout, or any normal human, you'd say he just moved to a northern city. But here's the surprising thing. Montreal isn't north, but it's not south either. It's almost exactly in the middle. So where on Earth is Montreal, and where exactly is the point between the North Pole and the equator? Where exactly is the middle? So how do we measure the Earth? You've probably seen one of these. This is a globe. At the top, we have the North Pole. At the bottom, we have the South Pole. And in between them, we have this line here. This is the equator. At the equator, we say this is 0 degrees, and at the top, at the North Pole, we say that this is 90 degrees. We call this number the north-south latitude of a location. You've definitely seen these numbers before. Here's a few examples. Bogota, Colombia, just north of the equator, has a latitude of 4.6 degrees north. Mexico City, 19.4 degrees north. And Iqaluit, 63.7 degrees north. So what is Montreal's latitude? How far north is it? Montreal's latitude is 45.508 degrees north, almost exactly halfway between the equator and the North Pole. This is surprising to a lot of people. Again, we think Montreal has cold and bitter winters because it is so north. But here's a few other cities around the same latitude as Montreal. Portland, Oregon, Bordeaux, France, Venice, Italy. These places have much milder winters than Montreal because of things like jet streams and complicated ocean currents. So although latitude does play a big part in our cold winter weather in Montreal, there are a lot of other factors to consider. So, Montreal's latitude is 45.5 degrees north. The halfway point between 0 degrees, the equator, and 90 degrees, the North Pole, ought to be 45 degrees. And that makes a lot of sense. South of Montreal, the border between Vermont and Quebec is at 45 degrees latitude. You'll even find towns on the 45th parallel that celebrate their halfwayness by putting signs up marking it so. And so, it's gotta be official. But there's a problem. This assumes that the Earth is a perfect sphere, and it is not. The Earth is actually squished a bit at the North and South Pole. It bulges a bit at the waist. It's not much. Earth is only about 22 kilometers wider than it is tall. But that means that the true halfway point between the North Pole and the equator is a few kilometers north of 45 degrees. About 16 kilometers to be exact. So let's go and find it. The exact latitude between the equator and the North Pole is 45.1433 degrees north. And there's not one single exact spot on Earth that marks the halfway point between the two. It's anywhere that is at that latitude. It could be here, 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 anywhere on this line. But what I want to do is find a spot that is south of Montreal and isn't in the middle of a pond or in the middle of a forest, someplace that I can actually get to. So in Google Maps, I'm clicking around and finding a spot that is at 45.1433 degrees north, and I think I found a neat spot. It looks like it's in a place called Aubrey. It's at this intersection, and I can see it here in Google Street View. So let's get in the car, drive there, and let's check this place out. Let's go to the exact halfway point between the equator and the North Pole. Okay, my eyes are on the road, I promise. I have just driven outside of Montreal, and the maps tell me that I'm about 20 minutes away from the place where I think is the halfway point between the North Pole and the equator. It doesn't say it on the map, but I believe I've done my work and have found the exact spot. So we'll be arriving in just a few minutes. It feels at one part very exciting, knowing I'm going to be in that spot, but then that's also part of, like, it's just going to be super underwhelming. It's just going to be like the side of a road, and it's going to be unremarkable. There'll be no sign, no fanfare, no fireworks going off. But I'm interested to see how I'm going to feel once I get to the exact spot. Okay, we're just a few minutes away. This feels like that scene from Shawshank Redemption where Morgan Freeman's character, Red, is trying to find that tree that Andy Dufresne talked about, to find the message that Andy left him. So, we're getting close. Okay, I'm pretty sure that I have found the location. It's right beside these post office mailboxes over there. There's even a post office worker filling the boxes right now. So I'm going to go there. I'm going to check my GPS coordinates at that location, and let's go and see if it's actually the halfway point between the North Pole and the equator. As far as I can tell, there is no sign here saying that this is the halfway point between the North Pole and the equator. Okay, so I've got my phone here. I'm looking for the latitude right here. It has to be 45.1433. So let's go on this blue dot and let's see what the latitude is right here. And it is 45.1433442. So this is it, right here. This is the halfway point between the North Pole and the equator. So I kind of expected that there would be nothing here, and it is just sort of like an everyday, normal, ordinary place. But it's strange when you're at a place like this and your mind is in this frame, it's in this mindset of expecting there to be something. And right now all I see is sort of this symbolism that we are exactly halfway between the North Pole and the equator. Some examples, I see this one sign over here, this two-way sign going left and right, right there. Sort of like saying, go north here and go to the equator on this other end here. There's also this other sign right behind me for this pole. And there are these arrows pointing right down at it. And it's as if it's symbolizing, yeah, this is the exact point between the North Pole and the equator. And there's a dog right here that looks like my dog. It actually kind of looks like Scout. He's looking at me now. Oh, he's coming closer. This place has a few signs, but none indicating that it is between the North Pole and the equator. So let's put up a sign. There's a part of me that thinks, like, if you were at the North Pole, you'd be standing there and you'd look at it and, like, this doesn't feel any different, but you would know deep down that you are at a very special place. Similarly, if you were at the equator, it would feel just like a very regular, ordinary, everyday place, but you would have that sense that there is something special about it. I'm getting that sense here, and maybe I'm just making it up because I've been working on this story, but yeah, every little interaction I'm having just feels like it's part of something special, something it's part of something bigger. Also, the fact that there have been two dogs that look very similar to Scout around here, it just makes this whole story come full circle. Look at him. He's going nuts. Just like Scout. Scout does this. All right, I'm going to go head back home now. Let's get back in the car. I have a strange experience. There it is. Nothing flashy. Just this Canada Post mailbox and an intersection. And also a few dogs that look like my own dog, which was the start of this video. So I think that is a fine finish, a poetic finish to this video.